excuse me a second. I just want to eat some of these chocolate dollars before I... Well, they're chocolate quarters. You cheap bastard. I just want to eat some of them so that they can't take them back when I cuss.
I imagine they'll find a way to take it back.
Oh, they know the way. Hey, can you vamp for a minute or two while I eat these?
Yeah, sure.
Go ahead, fill in.
So, you come here often?
Hey. None of that improv.
Crikey.
Talking to the... Oh.
Crikey.
Don't be talking to the audience. Do it on your own.
Guys, ever have a chocolate dollar?
Would you like one? All right, Geoff. You ready?
I am.
Okay. You ready for me to ask you what it is?
Yeah, I am.
Okay. What time is it, Jeffrey Peterson?
It's tweet mail time, presented tonight in the long-winded, tedious, wordy, verbose, windy, and redundant writing style of Charles Dickens.
Hey, whoa. Was that redundant in there? You can't call Dickens redundant. Dickens is an extremely important force in the English language. That's like saying Shakespeare is redundant. That's absurd, man, absurd!
Presented tonight in the long-winded, tedious, wordy, verbose, windy, and redundant writing style of Charles Dickens.
Ay, caramba!
Man, do the thing.
Twitter. Tweets will set you free. Try Ceratops. Twitter. Tweet the night with me. Check the tweets.
And also email.
The emails.
All right, Jeffrey. This is from Aaron in Madison, Wisconsin. You ever been to Madison, Wisconsin? Maybe you want to dance there or something. You ever been to Madison, Wisconsin?
It's a fantastic chocolate dollar.
Okay. Hi, Craig and Geoff. A recent date went poorly, but we both frequent the same bar. What do I say if I see him again? What do you think, Geoff?
They go to the same bar?
Yeah.
Well, don't go there anymore, dumbass.
No, she shouldn't have to give up her favorite bar just because this guy's a douche. He shouldn't have to go there anymore.
Yeah, I don't even care. Really, I mean, what is the point?
But you know, I think we're heading towards an argument.
You know, I think we are.
I think it's because you called Charles Dickens redundant, which, quite frankly, I've never heard anything more ridiculous in my entire life.
Well, you're the one that said Charles Dickens died in a hot air balloon and his mustache caught on fire. That's a bunch of bullcrap.
We'll talk about this later, when we're on our own.
Talk about redundant. Watch this show every friggin' night.
Crikey. Applaud Geoff in the middle of an argument. There's your dollar, you...
Crikey.
Oh, there's another one. This is from Sarah in Southwick in Massachusetts. Yeah. Dear Craig and Geoff, what should I do when I think someone's not paying attention to what I'm saying? This is from Manny in Miami, Florida. You ever been to Miami, Florida?
Yeah, sure, I've been there. Have you? I don't think you have. I don't think you've ever visited my place, have you?
I actually have been to Miami, Florida. I got a tattoo in Miami, Florida. And you know why? Because I've got skin!
You bastard.
That's right. I said it. Would you like a tattoo, Geoff? Because I've got a Sharpie!
You can take that Sharpie and shove it
in your hand. This is from... never mind. This is from Lola in Vancouver, Canada. You ever been... dear Craig and Geoff, you ever been to Vancouver, Canada, Geoff?
Yeah, who cares?
Dear Craig and Geoff, my husband forces me to watch hockey games with him because he says I'm good luck, but I'm not interested. How can I get him to stop? Well, stop being good luck. A little help?
The hell's going on in the audience, right?
This is from Mark. This is from Mark. I'm actually rather enjoying myself. This is from Mark in Savannah, Georgia. Now, I don't know if you can tell from this, but Mark's a duck. Can you see that there, Jeff? Yeah, he's a male mallard duck.
See that right there?
Yeah.
You know how I can tell he's a male? Because he has a penis. This is, yeah, Mark, have you ever been to Savannah?
I'm not talking to you.
Hi, Craig and Geoff. I'm 18 years old, but everyone tells me I look like I'm 12. Is this a good thing or a bad thing? Not touching it. All right. This is from... Listen, I did the child labor joke, and they practically... Ooh la la! Hung me! Did you see that?
I saw it, man.
Unbelievable! I was just trying to be a joke. I didn't mean to upset everybody, but oh, no! Apparently, the politically correct brigade are in tonight, and you've caused an argument between me and Geoff, and we've never had an argument before!
I hope you're all happy with yourselves.
I'm very happy! I'm sorry, man.
It's okay, man. I love you, man.
I love you, too. This is from Roy in Akron, Ohio. I don't know if you can tell from this, Geoff, but Roy's a fuzzy little tit. Can you see that?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Hey, Craig and Geoff, my girlfriend wants to go to a theme park, but I'm too chicken to go on any of the rides. Really? I thought you were a fuzzy little... What can I do to avoid having to go? Feign diarrhea.
Yeah, that's the title of my new autobiography.
All right, this is from Brian in Omaha, Nebraska. You ever been to Omaha?
Oh, yeah. Oh, it's my favorite.
Hey, I went to a hotel. The hotel I stayed in Omaha, Nebraska, I was in it, and it was haunted. It's a haunted hotel. I feigned diarrhea when I was there.
It's the only thing you really can do in this situation.
Dear Craig and Geoff, why do women go to the bathroom together? They don't. They don't. I'm married to a woman, and every time she goes to the bathroom, off she pops. It's only me and her in the house and the kids, and she goes to the bathroom, I'm left with the kids, unless she's got another woman in there, which would be awesome. But I don't think she has. I'd notice. Geoff, this is rubbish, isn't it?
Yeah, I don't pee.
Really, why not, Geoff?
Because I don't have a penis.
Did you just awe him? What the hell is wrong with these people?
I don't need your sympathy, people.
All right, Geoff, tell them what time it is.
It's time to go to commercials.
Yeah, it's commercial time. We'll be right back. Quietly, I'm sorry, Geoff and I had a bit of an argument, so we're just doing what we learned to do in therapy to get over it. We'll be right with you. When you say to me that I'm a bastard, it makes me feel less than.
I hear what you're saying.
Yes.
And I understand.
I don't think the crikey works.
No, I am still pissed at you.
And I you.
What did we learn on the show today?
So Geoff and I had a bit of an argument tonight, and we're working it through the way we learned in therapy. And what I like about you is you're thin. Now you have to say a thing you like about me.
What I like about you is you're funny.
What's that meant to me?
And you feign diarrhea very well.
All right, well, when we had our argument earlier... sorry, do you want some of this?
I'm good, man. It's just gonna fall right out of my mouth.
All right. Me too. I'm feigning. That's not true. I think Kenneth Branagh's gonna win the Oscar, though.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, he's great.
He is very good. Do you know who he's up against?
No, who?
I think Pauly Shore's up for, Biodome is up for, one.
That's our show, Redundant and Timely.
I'm redundant, he's timely. Well, in a way, he is. I mean, you know, I represent the redundant form of the late-night stand-up comedian, and he represents impending death.
Where are you all headed? Hi.
You see, so there's an allegorical subtext to what we're doing here. I know you thought you were watching a late night show, you'd smoke a doobie and everything would be cool, but everything is not cool. I'm kidding, everything is cool. Is everything cool?
Everything is cool, man.
I didn't know you could do that. Is your hand okay?
Yeah, it's good. Yeah.
Yeah, well, they said to me before the show that your hand was malfunctioning and it was going off at odd moments.
No, sometimes it has a mind of its own.
Mine too. Well, I think we all learned something tonight.
What did we learn?
Hmm?
What did we learn?
I don't know. Tell you what I learned. All of the people in this audience, never coming back. I'm kidding.